Good morning, children. Once more, welcome back to your maths class after your summer vacation. I think so, my children, you all did your homework. All of you, did you all do your homework? Some are telling, yes, ma'am, we have completed our homework. So, did you all learn the multiplication tables which I sent it in your assignment? I sent the multiplication tables of 15, 16, 17, I think so. Three tables. Did you all learn it, my dear children, by heart? Because in your examination, you have to learn those, because those are very important in maths. You have to learn those. So in your higher studies, when you are going for, in your higher classes, then you will see that for your higher maths, then what you will see that when you learn the tables, so everything will be so much easier for you. When the big multiplications will come or divisions will come, then you can do the sums very easy if you learn the tables thoroughly by heart. So, I suppose you all did your mental maths also. On Friday we are having mental maths. Friday you will get in your assignment all the solved out sums which you are having for your, which you all had, which you all have had for your holiday homework, your summer vacation, okay? Holiday homework which you all had. I think so. I'll give it to you on Friday. And today, please, my dear children, I'm going for the new lesson. In your previous lesson, I did 1F. Okay? Today, I'm going for 1G, exercise 1G. So, all of you, open your book to page number 17, my dear children. You all are having copies with you, means the notebooks with you, by your side. So, first, you have to pay attention to what I am teaching you. So, what are Roman numerals? So, today, the chapter, it's a very short chapter. It's talking, and you should know it. Because when you are reading in the class, you will see that the classes are denoted by X, okay, then 1V, then V11, then this 3, 1, 2, 3. You don't write 3 like this, you write 3 like this. Your class 3, I write like this. So it's not an English alphabet or English numeral, it is a Roman numeral, a Roman numeral. So you should know this. And 3 is English numeral. Okay? So, you should know this. Okay, my dear children? Now, regarding your Roman numeral, I'm going to teach you what a Roman numeral is. You should know very nicely what a Roman numeral is. Okay? So, you have to see this very nicely. Roman numeral, it's written like this. 1. Okay? V. This 1 is 1. V is written as 5. Then, X is written as 10. This is also called Hindu-Arabic numerals. 1, 5, 10, which I wrote English numerals over here. It is also known as Hindu-Arabic numerals. Okay? Then, X is 10. Then, L is 50, then C is 100, D is 500, and M is more than 500. Any number which is more than 500 is denoted by M. Okay? And in your Roman numerals, none of the numbers are denoted by 0. You don't find 0 in any of the number. 0 is not there. No function of 0. Okay? So now it will come to your mind map. So how the numbers are written. So, see this. Pay attention. If a symbol is repeated twice or thrice. So if this symbol is repeated twice or thrice, then you have to add the number. That is that 111 means here it is 3. Suppose it is written XX. X means what? X means 10. Repeated twice means 10 plus 10. That equals to 20. So XX means what? 20. 111 means 3. Suppose here it is given LL. LL is given like this. LL means what? 50 plus 50. That equals to 100. Okay? So like this. It goes on with the Roman numerals. Then,
when any smaller value symbol comes after the greater value symbol, then add the smaller to the greater. So what is the meaning of this? I'll do it over here. See, it's given over here that when a smaller value comes after the greater value. Okay, suppose the smaller value, I'm taking 1. Okay, it is coming after the greater value. Greater is 5. This 5. Then we add the smaller to the greater. This one is greater. This one is smaller. If the smaller comes after the greater, then we add. So smaller after the greater. So smaller placed, okay, I have to write this, placed after the greater. So the smallest is this one, 1, and this one is 5, and this one is 1. So you have to add it. So V1 means what? 5 plus 1, that equals to 6. So V1 means what? 6. It's coming in your, it's clear to you? So add means what? When the smaller value comes after the greater value, then you add the number, both the numbers you add. So then it is called the, it's called the addition of the greater with the smaller, because the smaller is placed after the greater number. So this is how you write 6. So this conception is clear. So if a number is written like this, V11, so means what? 5 plus 1 plus 1, that equals to 7. So V11 means 7. Now X11 means what? X means what? X means 10. 10 plus 1 plus 1, that equals to 12. So X11 means 12. So when you see the Roman numeral like this, X11, it means what? It means 12. Okay? Now, so this portion is clear to you all? So see, the smaller number, okay? You write the smaller number placed after the greater number. Placed after the greater number, the smaller number, you have to add the numbers. Okay, this is what? The second rule. Then, when a smaller value symbol comes before the greater number, then subtract the smaller from the greater. Now, if the reverse thing happens, if this happens, smaller number is placed before the greater number, see, this one is X. X means what? 10. If 10 is placed after this number, so smaller number is placed before the greater number. See, X means what? 10, and here this means 1. So what you have to do? You have to subtract it. Okay? Subtract the numbers. So it means what? 10 minus 1 is what? 10 minus 1 is 9. So X1 means what? 9. Okay? X1 means, 1X means, sorry, I'm very sorry, 1X means 9. And X1 means 11. So you find this number when it will be followed after the greater number, then it is add before the greater number minus. Okay? Just keep this conception in your mind. After the greater number, add. Before the greater number, the smaller number, you have to subtract. Just keep this in mind, this conception. Then, so here some sums are given to you. So I'm rubbing this. All of you see this? I'm rubbing this. So for your syllabus, only this till X is given to you. 1, V and X. L is also not given, but you should know till this. C means 100. Okay? should know it. Suppose I'm going to this page, express 1G, I'm going to the exercise. Express the following Hindu Arabic numerals as Roman numerals. Okay, then. Okay, one sum I'm going to do, my dear children, please. X, 1, V. If the sum is given to you like this. So first what I will do, see this one. 1V, V is the greater number. So I give a 5 over here. Placed before, so minus 1, okay, and this one is what? It is 10. So how you will do this? 10, and here already it is given 4. You are getting 4 over here, okay, you are getting 4 over here, because here it will be minus, because 1 is placed before this greater value, so it will be 4 already, and here is 10 is given and 4 is given, okay. So this number is placed, this greater number is placed before the smaller number, means your smaller number is placed after the greater number. So what you will do, you will add it and it will be 10 plus 4, that is 14. Okay, see over here, see this very nicely. 1V, V is the greater number, you are taking 5. Okay, then 1 is over here, is placed over here. Greater numbers prior is placed over here, so it will be a minus. So 5 minus 1 is 4. It's very good. You have written over here. Then you are going with this X. X and this one is V. So 4. So what you will do? You will do it because X and this 4, when you see this, this 4 is smaller than this X and it is placed prior to it. Okay, after to it. Then what you will do? You will do a addition of it and it comes 14. Then. So first you will do the small one and with that you will go on with the big one. Or directly also you can do. You can do the sum like this also. X, 1, V. It's not complicated. You can do like this also. 10 and plus 5 minus 1. Like this also you can do how it is given in the book. Okay, they are taking over here and they are minusing it over here. But I think so. It's better you do this way, as it is given in the book. So it is 4 and 10 plus 4 is 14 over here. Do it in the way it's given in the book. No harm. The previous one which I did, that also stepwise you can do. And this one also you can do. Any harm. No harm. You can do any one you like. It's not working. All the markers. Where is my black marker? I'm going for the exercise. So number 1 is given 4 over here. So how you will write 4? 5 we know. 5 is V. 1 less. Less means here you have to write 1. Okay? So it's 4. Then when I talk about this, 15. 15. 15 means what? 10 plus 5. That is 15. When I break it up. 10 means X. 5 means, so this is 15. So this is 15x and V is 15. Then, when I talk about 32, 30 means X, 3x, 30 and 2, 1, 2. 32, it's very easy. 35, 31, 2, 3, 30 and 5. Now, when I talk about 19, 19 means how you will write this 19? XX means 20, but it should be 1 less. Put a 1 over here. 10 and 9, 19. Okay, you did it. Then, I'll send it in your assignment, but you do it yourself first. Do it in your maths copy. Okay. Number 2. 7. Okay, V11 means 7. V means 5, 5, 1, 6 and 1, 7. 7. See, X V1. XV1. X means what? 10. 10 and this 5 means 15 and 1. 16. So this is 16. Then XXX1V. XXX means 10, 20, 30. 30 and V1 means 4. 30 and 4 is 34. So like this you will do. Now compare and do it. So this all, you do it yourself. It's very easy, this exercise. This exercise is very easy. Do it yourself. I'll send it to you in your assignment. In the book only, it's done. See, my dear children, it's already completed. But I want you, my dear children, to do it first yourself. You will do it yourself. Okay, you can do it in your book also. But with a pencil, you can do it. Because orally, you can do it orally. Okay, it's very easy. You can do this lesson orally, but this lesson is very important. Okay, do this orally, and in your next class I will send this in your assignment. Maybe today also I can send the same in your assignment, because the chapter is very easy and you can do it. You'll find very interesting also. With the math stick also you can do it. See, so nice in your chart board you can do like this with your art paper and all this. If you do, it will look very nice also. With the math sticks you can do, it will look very nice also. Okay, when I get the project work for maths, then I will give this to do this. Roman numerals you will do, okay? We're helping with the math stick and all this. I will give the numbers, and those numbers you have to do with your math stick, okay? And you will send the photograph, and you have to send it to me in your, take the snapshot and you have to send it to me, and I'll give marks on that, okay? It's very interesting. It may happen that I can give this for your project work, okay? So do this lesson very nicely, my dear children, and in your next class, I'll go for your multiplication tables also, and I will teach a new lesson. That is your, whether I can do this revision also of this previous chapter, or I can go for addition and subtraction also. Because this chapter is your recap chapter. Leaving this one. The other lessons, the other chapters which you, the other exercises which you all got, I think so already you all did in class 3. And this one was the new one today which I taught. And addition and subtraction, I'll go over there. Okay, addition and subtraction. Okay, next class I'll do it. And you please, my dear children, do the homework and check it from my assignment which I'll send it to you. Okay, so bye-bye. Stay safe in your home.